Welcome traders to another video, and this time we bring together a number of different concepts by looking at especially oscillators, but also have a view on indicators in general. So oscillators and indicators essentially are calculations based on the price and volume of financial instrument and measure factors such as money flow, trends, volatility or momentum. Begs the question, why would we use such indicators? Well, within technical analysis, indicators are used as a measure to gain further insight into the supply and demand of securities. Indicators such as volume are used to confirm price movement and the probability that a given move will continue. Along with using indicators as secondary confirmation tools, they can also be used as a basis for trading as they can form buy and sell signals. So just to give you an example, let's put two indicators on the chart. One would be a volume indicator, and admittedly volumes, which can be found here in MetaTrader, are not kind of perfect for currency trading, because you always, in currency trading, this is a decentralized market, and you only have kind of a snapshot of what's going on. And when you look at it, you have quite a spike here in volume at a time when the market hits that low. So it clearly shows that the market shows a very strong interest at that level. And again here, when we come back to that level, the market has shown a very strong interest and has shown a bit of a sustained movement in the other direction. Right. So that would be one indicator. If we look at others that we've discussed, let's add the moving average, for example, which would be an indicator which is being plotted on the chart. And we discussed that in a separate video. So you can see that you could use one indicator, for example, volume, but there are others. We have stochastic indicators to on which we also had some webinars in particular in some videos. So if you want to have a look, please go to that particular video. The point I always try to make, also an ADX, is that an RSI, that you use them in conjunction with other indicators. So this would be an opportunity to use one indicator or an oscillator as a filter. And then you use a second one as a confirmation or a second one to get a specific entry or an exit signal. So technical indicators are calculations based on the past price and volume of the financial instrument in an attempt to measure factors such as money flows, trend, volatility, and momentum. We separate them broadly into leading and lagging indicators. First, leading indicators are those created to precede the price movements of a security, giving predictive analytics. And that would be something like Fibonacci, or have a look at when we discuss pivot points, they're clearly leading indicators. Then on the other side, they're lagging indicators, and they follow price movement, and if they're often being used to confirm a predicted move, right? So that's a very different view, and that's a very important distinction. So I hope that is clear to you. You should see that really in the context of all the other videos that we have created on the specific indicators, but I wanted to show you an example of how we can bring different indicators together on MetaTrader 4, and how you can use lagging indicators for confirmation and predictive indicators to get a sense of potential targets for your trading. Hope that was helpful. Good luck with your trading, and I look forward to seeing you again at another video. Thank you.